how do you think about the global warming nowadays? It's become worldwide troubles.
Well, it's hopefully to do something about it. Well, it is a problem. There's many causes. Global warming. It's hard to say, you know, what we can do about it. We can do something about all the rubbish we have, which is also a part of the global warming. And this is exactly what we do today. Simply go down and pick all these things up. I have to think about, many people think about Thailand as a tropical paradise, but it's not a tropical paradise when you see all this. And we have all the tourists coming just in 1.5 months. So let's just get all these things away, you know, so people can come down here and feel good about going down to the beaches and go around and see, wow, this is a beautiful place.
And how do you think you can advise to have a good behavior, try to do not littering on the rubbish everywhere? It seems like we can see everywhere on the island.
There's two different things that I will say can help quite a lot. One of them is say no to plastic bags, unless you really, really need them. We have many places you go in, you buy just a little thing, just a little, you know, bottle of water, and you get it in a plastic bag.
Yeah.
So just say
it's
no
not
to
plastic.
It's not necessary. Mm-hmm. So only get a plastic bag if you really feel you have to have it. The other thing is that if you drive around here in Phuket or anywhere else where I've been, is the lack of bins. Down here at Nahan Beach, just at my left, there is two bins only. And all around you see at least 20 plastic bags. So the lack of bins is a major problem. So if we have a lot of more bins and a lot of other places as well, then hopefully people can learn to put everything in the bin and not just throw them on the beach and everywhere. So bins and say no to plastic bags.
Or even you really want to use the plastic bag, you have to reuse it many times until you can't use it anymore and just try to throw in the rubbish bin. This is the best way. And do you have kids?
If I have kids?
Yeah.
No, not yet.
Okay.
But that's the problem, you know, with plastic is that people think, we throw them away, we throw them out here, and they're going to vanish within short time. The thing about plastic bags, they never vanish. They're going to stay here forever. So the day I will have kids, you know, they'll find the same plastic bags, and their kids will find the same plastic bag, and soon they will be out in the sea as well. So
it seemed like both from the sea and also from the land.
Absolutely. I mean, when you throw a plastic bag in on land, you know, you just have a little bit of wind and weather and it's in the sea straight away.
Now we are with one expert. He lives around on the Rawai nearby Nahan Beach. Yeah, it seems 2 years. Okay. May I have your name? And
Tommy. My name is Tommy. I'm from Germany. Mm-hmm. And I'm coming to the Nahan Beach almost every day.
Yeah.
If it's sunny day, I'm here for sure.
Uh-huh.
You know.
Yeah.
So, and I like to see a clean place, you know, a clean Nahan Beach, you know. But the main problem here is why it's not clean is because no containers here.
Oh, no containers.
No containers to put in the rubbish, you know.
Uh-huh.
There's only one for this whole area, you know, and this is not enough.
Yeah.
There should be place more containers here. In this area, minimum two. In this area, two. In this area, maybe 6-7, you know. The whole place, maybe 15, around 15, 20. And a special place, there must be one exactly here, because so many rubbish here all the time.
It should people, be like you said,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. This is the main problem. There is no containers here. You know?
This is why people lazy to litter in the container.
Not if there is a container, maybe the people will do it.
But
if there's no container,
they don't bother.
What they can do? Nobody take the rubbish at home, you know.
This is the comment from expert who live around here, and then any organization who concerned with this thing.
That's the only one thing I have to complain here.
Yeah, you should you should follow their suggestion. Yeah, thank you. So do you plan to have idea to have this kind of activity in shortly coming up again?
We've been talking together with ScubaCat again about doing something on a regular basis. My wish is if we have possibility to do it, but we need support as well from the local community. We will very much like to do things like this at least once a month. Mm-hmm.
Maybe it's a good idea.
Exactly, yeah, and take maybe different beaches. But I mean, the best thing that can happen is that we get some support from the local community and the authorities as well. So if we can sit down together and come up with some plans about how to make Phuket really, really clean and a green area, that'll be a great, great, great thing.
And also, it's a good idea also try to do not littering split up everywhere. Just try to do it in the rubbish bin and separate on the rubbish, plastic, paper, or any kind of natural products that this can absorb. Just try to separate and throw in the rubbish bin. This is the best way. Otherwise, it's they have to participate a lot of people to have this kind of activities. It's fun at the same time, and it's also the hard work if you try to throw the rubbish on the time, and this you have to. It can say like you waste your time as well to do this kind of activities, but to be a good sample for both local people and also for tourists to have this kind of thing, and should everyone change your behavior to litter in the rubbish bin, this is the better way, and you have no other choice. Yeah. And any suggestion to local people or tourists to give you an idea?
Well, think twice before you throw anything away. That might be the best suggestion. Just think twice where you dispose all your rubbish. Do you really want it to throw in the bin, or you want it to throw in the nature so your kids can find it the next couple of years? That's the best advice I can give you.
And you said your plan to have like a monthly this kind of activity as well, right?
As I said, we've been talking about it, ScubaCat and Contiki together, about doing something on a regular basis. But it's still a long way because it's a pretty new thing. Mm-hmm. They do it in different parts of Thailand. I know like Koh Tao, they're really, really good at doing these regular beach cleanups. And as a tourist destination, like the biggest one in Thailand, we should do the same thing.
Like become the big issue now, like lots of hotels around on the island, they try to have these activities and they participate, become a big group and divide to each beach to clean it up. It's a good idea for everyone.
They can always go to our website. We have a contact information on on www.contikithailand.com. And they can always send us an email and sign up for the next beach cleanup. We have people done that already. But otherwise, I mean, if people really want to do something, there's a lot of other people who wants to help and support. The thing is that we don't talk too much together right now. Yeah. So we just need to find each other. Mm-hmm. And that's what I said, is like we need the local community and the authorities to sit down together and come up with a plan about what to do in the future.
So now you see what they have done, the excellent job. So this is all on the rubbish. And please save our island to make it clean and our planet. Thank you very much for watching on TV Phuket English Channel. And see you next time. Bye bye.